Okay, so extreme stresses we have calculated. So extreme stresses at bottom, they have given us a condition. So extreme stresses at bottom of the beam. So value we have got here, by the condition which they have given, the condition they have given, when the extreme stresses at edges will be zero, in that case what will be the value of eccentricity? Okay, if the eccentricity value kiti asnar hai, that value here, after putting the all values here, so after putting the all is here, we have got the eccentricity value 85.09 mm. So this is first case answer, and you can face such types of problem also when they have ask you people to calculate the eccentricity based upon the conditions. They are going to provide you the condition. Based upon that condition, you have to calculate the eccentricity. Okay. So next thing, case number two, we have to consider now. So case number two. So case number two. When the tendon is pressed, is it concentrically? When the tendon is pressed concentrically, which thing you have to calculate here in the problem? Which thing they have asked to find out? So in the problem, you can see here. In the problem, ask you, see here, if the tendon is concentric, what should be the magnitude of pre-stressing force? Which thing we have to calculate here? We have to calculate pre-stressing force. The tendon concentric particle, what should be the pre-stressing force for the resultant stress? Adava condition par baga, see the condition. What is condition again here? We have to calculate pre-stressing force, but which condition? For the resultant stress to be zero at the bottom fiber of the central section. म्हणजे प्रत्येक condition दिली आपल्याला. For that same condition, we by considering the value of now eccentricity and pre-stressing force, eccentricity and the zero is about stress bottom, we are going to calculate the pre-stressing force. Okay, so let the pre-stressing force assume. We have to assume that pre-stressing force. So let the pre-stressing force, let the pre-stressing force applied concentrically be P Newton. So we have to consider the assume that value of pre-stressing force is P here. Now we have to calculate first direct stress now. So what is direct stress? Direct stress, how we are going to get the value of direct stress? So direct stress always P by E, you people know. And we have calculated the value also. So here P by A, if I am going to put P is now unknown here. So just I am going to put value here, P into cross sectional area. Area of beam you have calculated 46,400. So this is Newton per mm square. Okay. So next thing now, extreme stresses due to dead load bending moment. So extreme stress, whether I am audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So extreme stress due to dead load bending moment so that value already we have calculated. Okay, that value, see, extreme stress due to dead load bending moment plus minus 2.19, that value we have calculated. So I can write that value here, plus minus 2.19 So plus 2.19, that value we have calculated. Next thing we have to calculate extreme stress due to the lye load. Extreme stress due to lye load, bending moment will be 7.56. So that value I can write here, plus minus 7.56 Newton per mm square, and this is also Newton per mm square. So after getting these all things, direct stress, stresses due to dead load, and distresses due to the bending moment. Okay, next thing, we have to, for condition of zero stress, for the condition, for the condition of zero stress at the bottom, for the condition at zero stress at bottom, so you can, we can write the condition here. What is condition? Stresses at the bottom. So here at bottom I can write like this, for bottom stresses, P by area 46,400 minus 2.19 stresses due to the dead load. And I can write here stresses due to the lye load, dead load and lye load. So by putting this value here, 46,400 is equal to, if I'm going to take these two value right side, what will the answer? Tell me the value. If I'm going to take these two value right side, 2.19 and 7.55.
9.74.
How much?
9.74.
So if I'm going to take this value right side now, what is value of P? That P is the concentrated force value. P is equal to, in Newton,
452 169
Newton. Newton. Check this value. So this how you got the value of distressing force. So they have asked us to calculate the stresses.
Sir, I am getting 451936. 451936.
Okay, other please check. Other someone, please let me know whether which value is correct. So someone.
451936.
451936. Whether this second one is correct then. Okay, so this answer is correct. So 451936 Newton. Okay, so this is how we have calculated the stresses. Now, what they have asked and what we have calculated. Once again, please see. For given this, for given section, they have given us condition. Condition kutla dilta baga ki asha thikani tendon provide kara in such a way that the stress at the bottom of the beam at for center span will be zero. म्हणजे टेंडन तुम्ही अशा प्रकारे प्रोव्हाइड करा की जे बॉटमला बीमच्या स्ट्रेसेस येतील ते स्ट्रेसेस झिरो मिळायला पाहिजे. मग त्याच्यामध्ये काय करायला फाइंड करायला सांगितलं आपल्याला, फाइंड द इसेंट्रिसिटी रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द प्री स्ट्रेसिंग फोर्स अँड बाय पुट युझिंग दिस कंडिशन इज हियर, बाय युझिंग एस्टीम स्ट्रेस एट बॉटम वी हॅव कॅल्क्युलेट द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ इसेंट्रिसिटी ई. ओके, केस नंबर सेकंड दे हॅव आस्क्ड, व्हेन द टेंडन इज प्लेस्ड concentrically, let the pre-stressing force applied on the pre-stressing force P, we have to calculate. We have used the formula pre-stressing direct stress P by A and other two things, dead load and lye load. We have added this and we have got the final answer here by using the condition. For the condition of zero stress, we have got the pre-stressing force as this. Got it? And in terms of, if you are going to calculate the stresses, you can draw the sketch like this. Case number first, jyachya madhe tendon aapla calculate karaycha hota. So in that case, This is I section beam. Okay, if I'm going to consider this one central axis for this, and how you are going to consider the stresses, first thing is the direct stress. So direct stress value here, P by A, we have calculated is equal to 5.08 Newton per meter square. P by A, 5.08 Newton per meter square. Okay, so this we have considered in a positive because it is in compression. And second thing, we have calculated the eccentricity due to the tension, due to the eccentricity. That we have calculated 0.055 into E, 0.055 E. This we have calculated by using formula PE by Z. Okay, and then we have calculated the stresses due to the dead load and live load. And at last, total we have got the section like this, stresses like this. This stresses at bottom is zero. Okay, and top here. So you can see here the stresses due to bending moment you have calculated due to dead load. We have calculated 2.19, and stresses due to live load we have calculated 7.55. And for this here we have used formula M by Z. So M by D here you have considered. Here we have considered L by Z. Okay, ML by Z. And here we have considered the that moment zero based upon the conditions. We have calculated these stresses. Okay, got it. And in case second, for T beam, this given T beam, for this given T beam, we have calculated first direct stress. And the direct stress value we have considered P by A. And that value here, 46,400. This we have considered plus. Here, this is minus, this is plus, this is plus. Okay, this is minus, this is plus, this is minus. And total this section is in plus. Okay. So for case number second, again we have calculated the same thing. We have calculated the direct stresses, and here we have not considered the eccentricity. Here we have considered only the stresses due to the dead load, okay, and stresses due to the live load. So this is 2.19, and this is 7.55. This is also 7.55. Here this will be in plus, plus, minus, minus. And at last we have got the section, the stresses diagram is like this. Okay, tension at bottom, okay, in beam is zero, stress is zero. Okay, so this full is in positive, and based upon by using these conditions we have calculated the pre-stressing force. Okay.